Hi, I'm Doug Molman. I'm honored to be allowed to serve here at NCC as part of the Elder Board, as well as having been a small group leader in McMinnville for a number of years. In my day-to-day job, I commute to various parts of Portland most days. With that, I frequently pass through Newburgh on my way home. A couple of months ago, I noticed a reader board sign posted at one of the storage unit facilities down by McDonald's. The sign read, "Today is the tomorrow you were worried about yesterday." That really stuck with me. I'm a worrier by nature. I'm not really sure why, but I've always been. I try to tell myself it's really about planning ahead, but the truth is, it's more about worry. Growing up, I didn't know Jesus, and my family didn't attend church. My dad was raised in a Christian household, and he liked to watch the Billy Graham conventions on TV, but that was about the extent of our involvement with any sort of religion. I never grew to understand what it was like to place my faith in God or to give things over to Him. I grew up trying to do things on my own and solve my own problems. As I've gotten older, I realized God placed a lot of faithful people in my life to help me grow and to learn to trust Him. My grandmother was a woman of great faith, but I didn't get to see her often or spend much time with her. I had several aunts and uncles who readily shared their faith as well, as my next door neighbors, Jim and Vanita Buswell, who were a great influence on me. As I went through school, I realized many of the friends I had made also had faith and had a positive impact on me. But despite all this, I still struggled against God and wanting to get to know Him more and to trust Him. I felt like I could go it alone. Later, God led me to my wife, Lori, who is someone with tremendous faith. I think I had a negative influence on her, though, as she did not attend church early in our marriage. I recall many of those first few years together where I spent a lot of time trying to figure out how I was going to support a wife and a new baby and was often filled with worry. Lori would reassure me over and over again and remind me that God would provide and that I should trust in Him, and she still does this. God finally put me in a place where I really needed to rely on Him. We had moved to San Diego for a big promotion I had gotten at work, and we were alone. He led us to a wonderful church family, coincidentally using a reader board, and we discovered what it was like to be a part of an amazing community. Despite the people God has put in my life and the ways He has allowed me to grow, I'm still a bit of a worrier. Just ask Lori, she'll tell you. But He has shown me so many times in my life how He has everything under control and to give it over to Him. My tendency is still try and hold on to these things, but He is making some progress with me. That reader board I saw at the storage unit reminded me of this passage from Matthew chapter 6, verse 34, which says, "So don't worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring its own worries. Today's trouble is enough for today." I think this is so important with everything going on right now. Information is changing daily, and we seem to have to pivot and adapt constantly. If we spend our time worrying about what tomorrow is going to bring, we'll miss all the good things happening around us today. So don't make today the day you're worrying about yesterday. I will keep trying to tell myself this, and I hope you will too.